we're going to start thinking about predictions. How do you see this one going?
I have to say, I got a favor in NiP for the first map. I think Dust 2, that goes in their wheelhouse. It's one of the worst maps for the VP guys. I think they've made a big mistake, and they're going to find out on map one they should have banned Dust 2 instead of Nuke.
Moses?
Yeah, scary for VP. I'm taking NiP as well on Dust 2.
All right, thanks, guys. So we're going to now do our map fly through with the classic Dust 2 and hand you back to Anders and Semler.
Thank you very much, Richard. And yes, indeed, we are ready for it here. NiP and Virtus.pro on Dust 2 coming up first. It's a best of three to decide who is going to make it into the semifinals and play at the Cobb Energy Center. That's going to be next week. I can't wait for it. I mean, this is a classic matchup, and it's going to be, it's just going to be pure fire, isn't it?
Exactly. This is the kind of map that'll go 30 rounds, that'll actually go all three maps in this best of three, that'll just go the distance because these teams know each other so well. I mean, we went on at great length on just how much history there is between these players. They've faced each other for over a decade, some of them. So, I mean, it goes way back.
Look at Getright sneaking up into the middle, but it actually feels like Bayani might see it coming. That smoke that goes up from the terrorist side is meant to help them get up into Catwalk, and Getright is right on the other side with the USP they're sneaking by. They check it, but Bayali, one look to the left might have saved the round for them right there and then, but they run into Freiburg, and he's going to pick up a kip kill. It's going to be Pyth as well. Freiburg one more time. Snack's going to be going down, and Taz to fall. It all crumbles. Virtus.pro not at all making it work. It's up to Neo. And with a little bit of luck, he might end up in a one-on-one versus Forest. That'd be perfect. There it is. Neo getting one more kill. He's looking for it. The two best players, and there it is. Neo picking up the quad kill. We just introduced it, and it happens. What a way to get started. All right. Now, we do want to introduce all of you, in case there are any new viewers, to how to watch this game. If you're new to it, you need to know that. So here we go. The top left, we do have the minimap that will show all positions of all players, and you need to watch that so you know where they're sort of moving around tactically. That's important. We also have this scoreboard that tracks kills, deaths, and assists, and also an X-ray function that allows you to spot players through walls. So definitely remember all those three things, and you'll be in a good position to watch the game. Second round coming up right away.
Yes, just to make it perfectly clear, those outlines that you see through the walls, the players can't see them. That's only for our viewing pleasure. So we get to get the hype. We get to see something that the players can't. But that just shows you how quick these players are, how quick their reactions are. When somebody comes around a corner, they're reacting instantly. They don't get a warning, an early warning like we do. But VP, they're going to manage to dodge the stack here from NiP. NiP kind of hoping that there would be some kind of presence in mid from Virtus.pro. Instead, it's Virtus.pro going straight out on long, up onto the A site. And this time, it'll work out a bit better here.
Yeah, actually not a risk-free scenario. It's possible in the second round here to pick up the Scout Sniper Rifle. So if you're walking up long like that fairly casually, if NiP had been up there with one or two Scouts, that could fall apart really quickly. Now, luckily for the Polish team, that doesn't happen this time around, but ultimately, just an easy round for them coming in here. They've hardly taken any damage, and NiP, I think, are just looking to get exit frags. They haven't bought any armor on NiP either.
Exactly. They haven't bought any armor, so they're looking to actually get as many grenades as possible in the round where they can afford to buy rifles. It'll be the fourth round in a couple rounds now. So NiP right now, what they're doing, they're staying on pistols to save up money so they can afford to buy the more expensive firepower stuff. Exist is going to be able to find a kill on Pasha, so that's certainly going to help, and he gets a MAC-10 out of that as well. So a little bit of a gun to work with in the next round. Hopefully for him, if he can survive, nobody's going to be anywhere near him, so he will be able to carry over the MAC-10. And now I wonder if he's actually going to get to, if he's going to invest a little bit of money, buy some Kevlar, just to give himself a little bit more oomph behind that MAC-10 to work with here.
It actually does annoy me a little bit because both Freiburg and Pyth could have picked up a scout each. All right, Abilo trying to arm wrestle Pasha, that is brave.
That's a bad idea.
I'm trying to think about who we could have to maybe do it. Actually, maybe Heaton from NiP could do it. That could be a fun, you know, fun arm wrestling match.
I could see it. I could see it. He does have the Viking in him. And Heaton's like 2 meters tall. Or, I don't know. How tall is that in feet? It's like 6.5 feet.
I don't do maths at all, especially not on live television. It's not worth it. Definitely not worth it. So we have another round here, and again, the scoreboard will already tell you that NiP don't have enough money to buy. You see 3,000, and to get a full buy-in on the CT side, you're going to need sort of 4,300 plus to get, you know, both a good rifle and the grenades and the Kevlar vest that you want. So they're a little bit short. It's going to be into the next round where the round loss bonus is really going to start to kick in, and they can finally buy something. And again, Virtus.pro making a really good choice. Again, they can't see the minimap, and they certainly can't see the X-ray outline. So they're just basing this off of a little bit of intuition and also just some some really sort of careful work. They're not rushing into anything, they're just being thorough.
Well, they have the rifles, right? They're looking to take the long-range fights. The pistols, they're going to be weak against the rifles long-range, and so Virtus.pro, they're like, they're going to the longest part of the map where they can actually just take long-range fights and make use of the rifles that they've invested the money into versus NIP's pistols. So, that being said, Freiburg just hits a beautiful shot onto Snacks. They're putting some pressure on. Getright's going to find a headshot on Neo. All of a sudden, things are getting a little expensive here for Virtus.pro. They need to be careful. NIP definitely not looking to hold on to the gear for the next round. They want to get in here and take a fight, try and make this expensive for VP, but VP, it looks like they'll be able to stabilize, although there is a flank coming in from long.
Yeah, and the great thing is they're exiting through long. Actually, they're just going to get shot down, but that was a pretty good call for NIP. They take away two rifles, they make it a bit more expensive. Now they can buy. Pith already picking up the AWP, and I'm wondering if that was going to be the only one. I think maybe they could have actually afforded to go for the straight double up setup, but they're just going to have the one in there. But none on Virtus.pro, and that's interesting.
I'm keeping us guessing. We were saying that Forrest, you know, he seems to be the primary opper now for NIP. But that still kind of shifts from map to map with Pyth. Pyth has that ability to go for the sniper rifle as well as the rifle. He can choose that actually gives NIP some more depth in their strategy because they can choose to be a little bit more difficult to predict where is the sniper rifle going to be on the map. And so for now, Pyth seems to be hanging around over on long to see if he can't find a pick over there. But VP, not interested. They're actually setting up for a very quick mid-take.
Wow, yeah, and you can look, NIP are completely out of position. Forrest outside of the bomb site. That's not a good spot to be in. They're just going to overwhelm him. Pasha to get up the kill, and now Get Right alone inside. He tries to push out and actually catch them off guard instead of just waiting inside, and that's just not going to work out. What a brilliant round coming out of Virtus.pro. An extreme change of pace that just completely caught NIP off guard. Freiburg going to be going down. Neo with a triple, surviving on one health and a 7-1-1 scoreline. Well then.
I'm glad to see this lack of hesitation coming in from VP. That pistol round to start things off here on this map definitely looked a little shaky from them. They got bogged down on catwalk, and they definitely looked a little hesitant. Ever since then, though, they've just charged out, taking control of parts of the map, and taking advantage of that, getting that bomb plant down. And so in this round now, again, it's going to be NIP just saving up their money. They're going to be sticking on pistols and hoping to be able to buy some rifles in the next one. That's not something we see so often anymore, but the wallbang headshot from Snacks takes down Forrest.
Yeah, so just again to reiterate, if you buy those big sniper rifles, you could do it with AK-47s, but especially that AWP can shoot through walls if they're thin enough and if they're made of the right material. So in the middle there, Forrest not even getting a chance to cross over, and then that's going to be a bit of an issue. They have a scout on Freiburg, but you can tell, again, NIP just don't have the money to buy here. Exist trying for the Deagle headshot. He's going to get one, but it won't be enough for any more than that. So still a comfortable position here for Virtus.pro.
Alright, they should be able to lock down a 5-0 lead here. And so that's the main thing. The score line, you can see it at the top of your screen. 4 rounds right now on the board for VP, 0 for NIP. It's the first team to 16 rounds. It's best of 30. And so it can go for quite some time.
Yeah, and that also allows us to talk about the fact now that NIP have actually lost 5 rounds in a row here, that their round loss bonus is at a max. You start off by losing, by getting 1,400 for a loss, and it caps out at 3,400 after you've lost 5 in a row, so it sort of progressively gets more and more money for losing. That means they can easily buy, and they will use all of that money, Semler.
Yeah, they're going to go for that double op setup. So, not wasting any time now. They saw that the single op didn't quite work. Now Forrest is going to be able to back up Pyth with that sniper rifle, so they'll both be using the AWP. And so what usually happens on Dust 2, usually what you'll do is you'll have one sniper rifle on one side of the map, the other one on the other bomb site, and you'll try and just lock down, just, you know, split the map in half and lock it down. VP, though, they aren't wasting time again, but this time Pyth on the edge of the smoke will pick off Taz, and there was no reply from Pasha. He gets bogged down, and he isn't able to trade the kill.
Yeah, actually, NIP is the team that came up with that extremely brutal way of holding long, where you throw Molotovs and HE grenades in, and it became super popular for a while. Weirdly, earlier today, we didn't see that much when Astralis were playing mouse sports on this map. It wasn't a big feature of it, but NIP have been really into doing that for a long time. So if I was Virtus.pro, I wouldn't ever try and take long early on. I'd just leave that alone.
If they establish the economy, right? I think maybe what's going on with VP is they're thinking, still a 6th round. Not going to be totally rich yet, NIP. Maybe they're skimping on a few nades, but NIP, even basic anti-rush nades there worked marvelously well. They get the first kill in this round, and now they have the edge. They don't need to take any risks here, NIP, on the CT side. They can just sit and wait and run down this clock, force Virtus.pro to come and take the fight.
Yeah. Pyth joining up with Freiburg down there. That does leave a lot of control on catwalk in favor of the Polish side here, but shutting down one player is Pyth, and he gets a second one too. They did get Exist in return, and Snacks is going to help out. That brings it into a 2-on-3. If Snacks get the bomb plant, and with Pasha in the middle, It might work out. Get Right though is rotating all the way through T's spawn, so he's on a huge flanking mission. Pasha picking up the kill on Forest. Now it's a 2-on-2, and look at Freiburg. He's down to 10 health. Pasha with the knife out is going to get caught. They had no clue that Get Right was going to be there. And now Snacks, 1-on-2. It's definitely doable.
Snacks' uncanny ability, or Get Right's rather, to be in such a surprising place. And a shoulder peek from Get Right as well. Just barely peeks forward, draws the shot out. That gives him the info, and then he just jumps onto Snacks. What a play from Get Right. Just a step ahead every bit of the way there. Just wow. Catching Pasha off guard in mid, and then totally baiting out Snacks, not walking into Snacks, who's prepared for that shot.
Yeah, and you see some of the grenades coming out. In fact, the two Molotovs that you see thrown there in the replay are meant to counter some of the likely positions that NiP would be in, and there were no players there. So that's essentially just sort of a waste of time and grenades from Virtus.pro that they could have used later on. And obviously, Pythia playing a really big role. Triple kill for him in the round with that sniper rifle. And he didn't appear to be smoked or flashed. And that's a problem for Virtus.pro. If you want to do that kind of a catwalk take into the A-bomb site, you need those flashbangs.
Now we'll see a bit of a change coming in here from VP. They're about to test Forest. Forest, they managed to save both AWPs and IP. So Forest will be over here on the B site, the other bomb site on this map, with the sniper rifle looking into upper halls. And all five members here from Virtus.pro ready to just go bursting through the smoke. If an AWP is here, he's going to have one shot. It's all on Get Right now. He tries to go for the flash. It's not effective. Pasha's still going to lose that duel. But Forrest, he stumbles. That costs him valuable time. Doesn't matter in the end. Get Right catches them all lined up. And a quad kill for Get Right. All four. Two rounds on the board now for NiP.
There really is one big rule when you try and go for a B push like this. Don't stop in that doorway. Just if people get lined up like this, it is just not going to work out. It actually looked like NiP were in a very bad position to deal with that. Forrest had just exited the window to go in the middle, and Get Right in that corner is 9 times out of 10 just going
to
die.
He's supposed to get traded instantly, and it's similar to what we saw in the pistol run. Some hesitation there from Virtus.pro. One guy goes out, he dies, but where's the follow-up? It needs to be, they need to be forming a conga line. First guy goes down, doesn't matter. The second guy's gonna be there to trade the kill, and they get the bomb site. That's how it's supposed to work for VP. So if we see hesitation like that, it'll cost them, especially if you give Get Right the opportunity to line you up that way. So now, I mean, 5-2 for Virtus.pro. They're still in the lead, but NiP now, they're gonna be starting to feel a little bit more confident. Things are starting to come together for them.
Yeah, and you see four sniper rifles in play right now. That immediately tells you that we're playing on Dust2. That doesn't happen on that many other maps where you'll see this kind of setup. We'll see if it's going to work out. Snacks and Pasha both very capable with the AWP, and Snacks showing exactly why pre-aiming that position exists even up on the box there, and Snacks just knew.
Yeah, that's not a common spot to be holding from. You hardly ever see that anymore, and Snacks still dead on. And so this heavily favors Virtus.pro. Now NiP have to cover more ground with less players. They have the four players still alive, and two of them focusing on that A site hard. Pyth is there by the cars towards the A site looking to catwalk with that AWP, so we saw how effective he was with that earlier. Not a bad position for him to be in. But right now, Get Right's trying to cheat his way over towards that A site. He wants to be able to rotate in, back up his teammates quickly, and he's already gonna get the read. Taz drops, he's not gonna get the follow-up though. Neo is there to get the trade instantly. And now, exactly, Pasha gonna pick off Forrest. Neo catches Freiburg, and the smoke is working against them in the end. Neo just going to work. Three kills for him.
I mean, I got pretty hyped up watching that intro with Neo and Forrest, just, you know, who's the better one. And right now you see Neo at 12-1-3, which is absolutely incredible. It's almost like he ended up watching it too and felt like it was time to make a move, because the story really was, right? Neo's so good in 1.6, Forrest maybe trying to overtake him in Global Offensive, so maybe Neo felt like it was time to get back into it.
I just love Neo, though. He's just the most humble guy you're ever going to run into in the pro scene. He's like, not for a second is he entertaining the thought that I may be the best. He's just like, no, Forrest is the best. You know, that's no discussion. And yet he will still just wreck you like this, one-on-one, no problem at all. Take the fight to you. He has no fear. He shows no fear. So 4-on-4 scenario now. Forrest gonna miss the shot. Now he could get caught. They're gonna push out from upper dark. He knows that. Tries to take the fight to him on B slope, but he will get caught. Neo is there.
It's such a hard thing right now for NiP to hold that B bomb site. Freiburg and Pyth are gonna be left 2-on-3. Since the bomb is not down, they can technically wait around and try and see if they can snag a quick kill on someone. But otherwise, retaking the B bomb site with unfavorable numbers is almost never worth it. Even if you are in a straight 3-on-3, it's hard to retake. And if you're a man down, you might as well not even try.
Nah, it's those choke points. It's just a bit brutal.
We'll see. Right now, they're just waiting around here. M4 on Freiburg and Pyth with the AWP waiting for it. So they're just going to save the rifles. And the key to why they're doing that is the scoreboard. They have almost no money. Said they need 4,000 plus to get a real buy-in, and it's not looking good.
Yeah, that's the main thing, exactly. They need around 4,000. Between 3.5 to 4.5, you'll start getting a healthy buy. And so you can see they just don't have enough money. So we should see NIP once again with the three pistols.
So here's the challenge that you're facing if you're inside the B bomb site. There are sort of three main entrances. The one going in from upper dark, there's the main one in, and then there's that little window that they creep through. So if you're on the CT side defending in here, you got three angles to cover. It's just not a good position. And that's exactly what keeps happening to NIP here. They keep having to cover all these three entrances. And it's not working out.
Yeah, they're getting caught. They need some more support. Maybe we'll start to see that. Again? A double wallbang? Both of them hit the shot? Pyth will be able to trade. He takes down Snacks. Pasha attempts the flick. He's not going to get it. Maybe able to get the follow-up, however. That is actually pretty brave of Get Right jumping around trying to save that rifle.
Yeah, but on the other hand, it's all they got. So, I mean, you got to think, actually, this is pretty good for NIP. They do lose Freiburg, but they could just keep picking up the orb and taking even more fights. Something Virtus.pro should be avoiding right now. Forest and Exist trying to make a play in the middle, it seems, but not feeling too confident about it either.
Once again, Virtus.pro, they know that there's not too much economy going on for NIP right now, that they only have to deal with the two saved guns, and so they once again head out towards long. They want to look for those long-range fights, but bring the rifles to bear. In the meantime, Bialy's lurking his way out onto that B site. Early rotation coming out from Get Right, however, he's made his way into mid, and Pyth has no idea that the site has been compromised. We'll see if Virtus.pro actually try and play off this information, or it's going to come down to Bialy to try and draw attention to himself, get those CT players to rotate over towards that B site and open it up to allow for the VP guys to get onto the A site with that bomb.
Oh man, this is falling apart. Forrest is actually flanking on long. Bialy then ends up flanking. Pyth, who had the AWP that they needed to cover the cross there, and that doesn't work out. So very patient stuff. Great drawing skills. I like that. Maybe, I think there wasn't time to sort of properly color it. They just did the outline. I like that, though.
The question is, did like Pasha lay his arm down on it, right?
Look at that. That's actually from Freiburg's point of view. He's not even trying to take that fight. They throw the grenade in, as you can tell, and the debris from the explosion is going to obscure the view from the sniper on the other side, and that still doesn't work. That's something they do almost every round, either that or a smoke, and still Pasha got the kill. 8-2 in favor of Virtus.pro. What a strong start for the Polish side.
What is this lurk, Taz? He has no idea where he's getting shot from. He just runs through the smoke and gets completely caught off guard by Forrest. Okay, I mean, you're ahead 8-2. I suppose you can start taking a couple risks here and there, see if they pay off. But this time it's going to be Forrest. He was standing in the right place at the right time, and he'll get that opening kill for NIP. And so it's up to VP now. They're down a man to try and bring this back.
It's one of those feel-good moments, you know? He thought that was going to work out, but obviously didn't happen now. Exist taking up a dangerous position, but also one that works really well if Forrest is going to be there to help him out. And he's in the middle with the rifle right behind him, so it could definitely be working. Pyth is in his usual position, but not with his usual gun, and that's a big difference. Normally, you want the sniper rifle to cover the catwalk here. He's got a FAMAS instead, and that is nowhere near as good. Pasha on the other side. I think Pyth spotted him. That actually is a really good peek coming out there. 50 seconds on the clock, and Forrest is going to take down Neo. It's now 2-on-4, and Pasha and Snacks left. 45 seconds, see if they can clear out this round. First, they need the bomb plant down. Pasha close to the edge. I don't think they realize, but Forrest is walking right up next to them. They're looking the wrong way. Forrest with one, and a second one, too. That's a quad kill overall. Forrest taking down almost all of Virtus.pro on his own.
And we're just having these standout performances between Neo and Forrest right now. I mean, you're right, doing those videos, doing those interviews, certainly fired up Neo. I mean, he's taken off completely. 17-2-5 for him. Forrest, he's had a big round now, but they are still trailing behind, actually, right now. On individual performance on that level, NIP, everybody's still in single-digit kills. It's not quite good enough. They need to start putting some bigger plays on the board.
A very important round for the Swedish Ninjas, as they were otherwise going to run out of money now. The economy in the game, which is such an important feature of Counter-Strike, it's roughly even. There's a pretty good bank on Neo, but everybody else on VP is low on money. Same is true for NIP, so whoever loses this round is likely to be going into the next one with some pretty bad rifles, and we'll see how that works out. Bialy, very quick up catwalk. This is unusual. You normally don't just run in this far. Taz going to be going down. That was just Get Right. Pure intuition to pick up that kill, and they get a kill on Pasha as well. Pyth in position, followed up with an incendiary grenade, and this is just a round that's falling apart for Virtus.pro.
Yeah, the defense actually starting to make the adjustments necessary. Getright, obviously, always so good around the smokes, knows how to take advantage of the edges where it gets a little blurry, catches Taz off guard, and then it all falls into place nice and neat for NiP from there on out. And they're just going default. They aren't doing anything special, particularly in this round. It's very spread out defense, three on A, two towards B. Although Getright, of course, working his way through T-spawn, so he's looking for the long-term flank here. But it's going to be forced to find the kill on Snacks and Getright long range from T-spawn. Bialy would have never guessed. And so 8-4, NiP. They get that fourth round on the board, and there's still money. That's how good this first half has gone for VP so far. They still have money in the bank. NiP, they win rounds, but they just are not able to get Virtus.pro to have to spend a round on pistols. There's always going to be money for the rifles.
All right, there we go. Nico.
Hey, Nico.
Already through to the semifinals and still watching the game and enjoying it. And remember, whoever wins here are going to be facing Mousesport, so he has a really big interest in watching this game. I also talked to him, and he said he'd love to play Virtus.pro. So, I mean, from the looks of things right now, that might well happen. VP, they're on fire. NiP, they're starting to get back into it, and if they can just win this round, then they will finally put the Polish team back on a Nico round, which means they won't have money, they'll just have pistols. We'll see if it's going to work out or not. Both sniper rifles in play for NiP.
This is one of those big make or break rounds, you're right. VP so far, they managed to weather the storm. There's the short smoke. So you can see Forrest now blind, just putting shots through randomly, hoping to get lucky with the timing. It's not quite working out for him so far, though. They are managing to sneak right by. And so three players with the bomb will make their way up on a catwalk. And now it's about VP clearing out this part of the map to open up that A site.
Just a little bit scary going on catwalk there. You hear the shots raining in right behind you on the wall then. The problem is, there is another sniper rifle, and it's covering exactly where they're about to head up. You can even see the sort of the tracer there outlined. Pyth down on long and ready and waiting.
My one concern is that NiP are very low on grenades now. 45 seconds left, they only have three flashbangs to try and slow VP down, and VP, plenty of nades to put to use. They're all not really going with it, though. There's a delayed flash, not stopping Pyth, though, from picking off Pasha. And he can get that flick. He is going to get that headshot onto Snacks through the smoke. Bialy there to trade it, but the damage is done. Exist holds from Goose, and now it's just Neo alive in a 1v4. And not for long. Freiburg will snuff him. 8-5. And this is very interesting. VP keep putting themselves into advantageous positions by the looks of it. They have superior utility, superior grenades. They have the positioning advantage as well. And yet they just aren't able to execute. They aren't able to get onto the site.
Right, but also as you realize there, the smoke that goes up, the second kill that Pyth gets is sort of through the smoke, right? The first one, there's no smoke covering him, and that's obviously a big issue. Virtus.pro end up pushing before they actually block off the enemy sniper, and that is definitely not ideal, so maybe something that you just can't afford. Now, almost no Kevlar on the terrorist side, and just pistols here, so this should be an easy round for the Swedes, but we'll see if it's going to work out or not. Freiburg down in the pit, Pyth there fighting furiously. They're getting real close with these pistols, and he's finally going to be going down. Freiburg dies as well to Neo, so a bit of an expensive round right here, but it should be pretty much the end of it.
Whoa. I don't know. That's a pretty hit. That's a pretty sick headshot. Takes down Forrest. Bomb is still there for Neo to pick up. He's just hoping to get lucky here with another headshot if he can. If he can find a rifle, that'd be pretty good as well. Now he's got the AK. Goes for the peak, reloading. Well, that's not a mistake you can make against NiP. They're too quick for that. They will find you. 8-6 now. And NiP, I mean, they've certainly made a comeback in this half so far. If they can finish this 8-7, that would be a fantastic scoreline for NiP, considering the start that they had in this half. It's up to VP now to just come back strong here and finish it. 9-6, that would be all right for VP.
Especially because the one thing you don't want if you're NiP is to allow that plow to get into to gear. So dangerous. Virtus.pro is one of those teams that if they really start to do well, then there's almost no stopping them. Mm-hmm. At times, it seemed like they could beat almost any team in the world. So, last round of the half coming up, you're right. And I think six rounds is even workable. Seven be great for NiP.
Oh, that would be very solid, because then you start to get into threat territory, the T side, where you can really start building the strats, figuring out where Virtus.pro, the defense is weak, and taking advantage of it. I mean, that's what threat is all about. And so we'll see. Already early pressure on the catwalk. Virtus.pro making sure that they have to fall back and continue to fall back into that default setup that NiP have been using so far. But now this actually gives Virtus.pro the option to go to B. If they want to go for the B split again, they haven't really hit it too much, hit that B site too much in this first half. So it could be a good way to end the first half here, maybe catch NiP off guard.
I mean, they did it early on and it worked really well. So you actually almost have to wonder why they stopped doing it so much, because on catwalk, they keep running into Pyth and he's really shutting them down. So I would agree. Split B bomb side right now through the middle, and I think you're exactly right. That's what they're gonna do. Taz already out. They're not even putting up a smoke. That's not gonna exist. Won't know that it's coming until it's too late. Getright gonna be going down. Exist is next, and now inside the bomb site is Pyth. They switched him up in here, and what a miserable task on his hands. Five people coming. He takes down one. Second as well. Oh, Pyth, what are you doing? He's looking for a third kill. He's finally gonna be going down, and Forrest has to fight this. There's no saving in the 15th round. So 1-on-3. I don't see it happening.
No, a bit tough to say, and he's even going for the flash just to check mid. It's effective, but he has no idea. He doesn't see the man up on catwalk. Certainly heard the shot there, though, and now he knows, but it's not going to help him. Snacks will not miss. 9-6 at the end of the first half here for Virtus.pro. Could have been better, but it's still an acceptable scoreline, I think, for them.
Yeah, I would say overall a fairly even beginning to this matchup here, which is exactly what we were hoping for. That's what we want. Surprised that Virtus.pro forgot about that B bomb site, because you see how well it worked as soon as they tried. It was just all VP. So just very, very impressive. This could be a really intense match. It already is. We'll be back after the break with the second half. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it was one hell of a first half, and now we're going to go into the second one. We did have this big overarching question, which is the best overall throughout all the iterations of Counter-Strike? Is it Neo or is it Forrest? And right now, Neo certainly trying to persuade a lot of people. Just look at this stat here. 21 kills on Neo to the 7 of Forest.
Oh, well, you know, we had that video at the beginning of this show where they asked each of these players, who do you think was the best? And Neo just said without question, Forest. Forest, of course. But what Neo realized is that actions speak louder than words, Anders. I only have 3 times the kills that you have, Forest. Come at me, bro. Let's go. Like, Neo, he is here to put on a show for us all tonight. Forest still needs to wake up a little bit here, and we'll see. Pistol round of the second half. NiP have flipped over onto the T side. Now it's VP on the defense on the CT side, and already we're about to have some action in mid.
Yeah, they pushed up Catwalk. Very aggressive here for the CT side to try and do this. We saw Getright try it, and it didn't work for him. But they've got a double stack here instead, Virtus.pro. If they win this pistol round, they'll be a really, really close to winning the first map. And what a headshot, taking down Getright, who was jumping. Neo coming out, he actually just turns around for the flashbang. He doesn't even care, and he's taking more fights. Eventually gonna cool it down. He's getting a little bit of backup and snacks with what looked like just a gap shot on Exist. Forest and Pyther left here, 2-on-4. And this is a very, very tough round to come back into. You can see Pyther trying and succeeding as well, taking down Neo. But it's a 1-on-3 for the Swedish player.
And we lose Forrest in the meantime, and so it's all on Pyth. He has the bomb, he has a single Molotov, a decoy grenade, and a USP. So he has that one-shot headshot potential now to work with, and he's certainly fast enough to make use of it. Doesn't really matter when it comes to Snax. Snax has 1 point of health, and so you could throw a grenade at him, and that would kill him pretty much here. So we'll see how this works out, if Pyth can get the drop on him or not. He seems to know that Snax is waiting in the pit, misses the shot. Snax still alive. Somehow Pyth is messing it up. They're both reloading. What's going on? Finally, who's going to get the kill? Snax is actually going to win it with 1 point of health. What? 10-6, and VP pick up the second pistol round.
Oh, man. I want to forget that immediately. If I could wipe that from my memory. At this level, the thing is, I don't think they realized how low Snax is. So Pythus shooting for the headshot because he thinks he's at 100% health. And obviously, if he had known it was 1, he'd probably go for the body shot instead. But still, a little bit ridiculous. And a good start for Virtus.pro. 10-6 here. NiP going to reply because they didn't get the bomb plant, which is they didn't get the bonus money for putting down the bomb. They're going to go for mainly Tech 9 and armor here, which is a very, very common strat.
Yeah, exactly. They just want to go for the run and gun. With the Tech 9, very accurate on the move, and so you can, and it does a lot of damage to armor. That's a very potent pistol, right? And so they can run quite fast and just try and zerg onto a site, just try and run straight onto a site and get that bomb plant. So we'll see if NiP will manage to do that. It's going to come up to VP now to kind of stop them cold. VP, they've invested in a couple of rifles, but they've also kind of, you know, saved a little bit of money by going for some SMGs and a shotgun on Pasha. So a healthy spread here for Virtus.pro. They just need to be in their good positions to actually make use of them. And well, look at that. Pasha. He's going for a bit of a gimmicky play. He's got the shotgun. He's just waiting to jump.
Yeah, so jumping and shooting in Counter-Strike is not something you generally want to do, but there are some exceptions to it, and the shotgun's definitely one of them. The Scout Sniper Rifle that we brought up earlier is another one. It is a gimmick, but it's been proven in the past that it can definitely work. NiP down to 45 seconds, so also running the clock a little bit low. They do have 2 smoke grenades to try and do this. We'll see if the biceps are going to be put into play here. They could run him down with the Tech 9s on the other side, and already there's the 1 kill coming in from Bialy, taking out Freiburg. Pasha going to go at it again. He gets the 1 shot, but actually they're trading great right now. NiP coming out on top, and now Bialy and Taz left in a 2-on-3. Have to try and see if they can salvage this round for Virtus.pro. NiP hitting back hard in the second round here. Forrest going to take down Bialy, and Taz with a UMP. This submachine gun is not meant to fight armor. It's not the best weapon for it at all. And he's gonna fall as well. Pyth to take him down, and NiP. Now things get very interesting.
Yeah, big round win there for NiP. That's about as good as it gets. We actually don't see that too often today, that the Tech 9 armor, you know, is successful, especially when it gets drawn out that way. But that's the problem with going with silly plays like that, with the Pasha play. You know, if he's actually just sitting there trying to get headshots, maybe it works, but he's wasting so much time jumping around.
I think you could even argue that on a map like Dust 2, Tech 9s are just less effective in general. Like, there are other maps where you can get closer with them, and, the whole run and gun scenario is more effective. Buy 5 Deagles on Dust 2, why not? Almost
exactly.
A better choice.
Exactly. There's these long areas on the map, A long for one, in the middle of the map, where the Deagle, you have that one-shot headshot no matter the range. So sometimes you actually see that fairly common now these days, that the Deagle gets picked up quite a bit over the Tech 9. Still. NiP, they're gonna be feeling great about that. That brings them right back into this half. Seven rounds for them. Still trailing DP, who have 10, but Exist behind the flash, gonna find the pick. He gets headshot in the process though and has to back out. Bit of a close call there for him. Neo, or rather Snacks, came pretty close to picking him off.
Three Deagles in play right now. Again, even with Kevlar vest and head armor, that Deagle will shoot in one bullet if it's a headshot. So that's why they picked him up. It's like a cheap version of a sniper rifle, but it could definitely work. Pasha is sneaking in behind, but he only has the USPS pistol, which is definitely nowhere near as effective. Neo, though, is in position up on the bomb side. Let's see if he could do it. He's got the angle for it. You can see he's lined up, so all he can see are going to be their heads. And there's the first one coming through. Neo going for a bit more, but he's not quite going to get it. It was impressive the first time around, but they're going to shut him down. And I think this is going to be the round for NiP.
Yeah, they are able to stabilize here. NiP. Forrest has still got quite a bit of HP, so you kind of want to see him take the fights, but it looks like Snacks doesn't want to have anything to do with this. He's going to be wrapping his way all the way back through T-Spawn, and well, Getright instantly moving to cover Pyth, who dropped earlier, doesn't want to let Snacks pick up that gun for free. And so we'll see, maybe Snacks can find Getright out in the open somewhere, catch him looking the wrong way, and could pick up a UMP to work with in the next round, but that's not going to happen. Getright wins the duel, and so it's 10 rounds on the board for Virtus.pro, 8 now for NiP, who are slowly working their way back into this map. And this is, just to specify, this is NiP's map pick. And
yes.
So they should be the favorite team. If you're going to pick the map, you should feel like, you should feel confident, you should feel like you should be able to get the win on it. So right now, we are seeing NiP stabilize a bit.
Still slightly blows my mind that Neo is up to 23 kills. I mean, as our analyst Duncan was pointing out, he's not the guy you expect on this team to be the top fragger. That's not what he's supposed to be doing. So the fact that he's putting this much work in is really quite impressive. And continuing into the second half as well. Pyth going to be going down. That was Taz picking up the kill with the CSET 75, which is so lethal at close range.
He didn't get a whole lot of information there, Pyth, either. He spotted one guy. But it does seem like that was enough for NiP to think we need to go towards the A site. Maybe there was a stack on B. We're not going to take that risk. We're just going to try and push out onto the site. Out in the open, Freiburg. Dink down to 1 HP, though, and Neo will find the kill.
Finally, the UMP coming into play. Getright with a really good double kill and a much-needed one. They're running out of players here. Getright making it a triple before he goes down, and now Exist no cover out in the open. They're shooting him down to 25 health. He's got plenty of time, but no health left. He's on 2 HP at the moment, and all they have to do, Pasha and Taz, is wait. He does not even have the bomb, so he can't even switch up bomb sites and go somewhere else. He's going to have to rely on them making a big mistake right now, and that would be fighting him one at a time. If they do that, then he could do it. If they both peek at the same time, this is done.
Yeah, they should be able to spot him. It exists, still letting him know. Hoping to get lucky through the smoke. It's going to tell Virtus.pro exactly where he's coming from. And while he still has 35 seconds left to play with here, but he's out of nades, he's only got the 2 HP, he has to get in here and look for the headshot. And while right now, VP, they're not going to give it to him. Taz will find the shot eventually, and that is another eco win. Not another one, but both teams now basically have won rounds with pistols versus a bought-up team. That is very hard to do. And so that's going to completely flip things on its head now for VP. That's a huge win for them.
Look at that. Look at that scenery right there. What a great combination. That looks very comfortable in Minnesota. I mean, this is ridiculous, isn't it? Normally, if you win the pistol round like Virtus.pro did, then you're going to be in a really good spot, right? But then NiP came right back, and this time it's Virtus.pro's chance to win with just pistols. So I can hardly believe it. We're at 11-8, and we've got 2 sniper rifles in play right here. So maybe the game is going to sort of stabilize a little bit.
Yeah, slow it down. NiP are going to want to give Forrest time to work. Trying to find that pick, that opening kill with the AWP. So he's currently exactly posted up in mid, hoping for somebody to take that peek. Virtus.pro do have a focus on mid. They have 2 players there looking at a crossfire on those mid doors. But nobody going to peek and give him a target to work with. So instead, NiP decide to force the issue, using some grenades to clear out catwalk.
Well, we saw how effective the B split, as we called it, that Virtus.pro did when they were on the terrorist side. We saw how effective that was. And actually, Virtus.pro, now that they're on the defending side, they're trying to stop that from happening. And that's why they have that big presence in mid. They don't want to be letting go of that B bomb site. And I like it. I think it's a solid idea, especially because it means they have less of a defense over at A, but the people posted up here, one of them is Snacks with the AWP. And I would put a lot of faith in him, too, to cover this position. They are making their way out middle by Ali. Right there, Molotov goes in. Bayani actually picks up that kill. Very good job. Getright going to be going down. Neo and CT spawn, and more people are coming in. Forrest trying to cross on over, but he need backup quick. Taz has to go down in that bomb site, and he's still not dead. Up on the box. Eventually he falls, but it might be too late right now. It's a 2-on-3, and there's almost no health left on NiP. They're going to go straight for the bomb plant, so at least they'll get the bonus money, and I think that's all they're going to get here. Exist, he's going to get the one kill, 1-on-2, and gets shot down by Pasha. Triple kill for Neo, who's now rocking a ridiculous 27 kills in the 20th round.
In the 20th round, that is nuts.
What an absolute legend.
That is exactly, that is a legendary performance. That's a star-level performance right there. And so Virtus.pro 12-8 now, they continue to extend their lead. And that was just some very quick thinking coming in from Neo. He was in the right place at the right time to back up Bialy. Bialy was the point man there, the first point of contact for Virtus.pro in CT. He was able to capitalize on it, but then Neo was able to follow up immediately behind him. And so just really solid work coming in between on the defense, basically. That's all about communication. Bialy saying, you have to go in, they're not looking your way. Take advantage of that. And in Neo, he's going to pounce.
Yeah, and that kind of a B-split is unusual or uncommon, because normally the B split is sort of the first sign you get on the defensive side that something is happening is the smoke that goes up right where Pasha's running past here into CT spawn. That's how you know that a B split is coming, and they didn't even throw any of those grenades in NiP. They were really quick in there. So it's a good job for VP to actually be surviving the round anyway.
Nice shot, right. Pasha. Okay then. Okay, Pasha, you're that quick. Again, just to remind you, he doesn't have the X-ray. He doesn't see that person through the doors there. And so he's reacting just in a split second. He sees movement, bam, he pulls the trigger and gets the kill. So fantastic work there from Pasha. And Ninjas in Pajamas, again, working their way, going through the motions. Once again, clearing out catwalk. But it looks like instead of heading towards A, they've had a lot of action over there so far this first half. They want to try and wrap back towards B, but that's going to cost them another player. Pasha finds a second kill.
Now, how are they possibly going to make it in? Taz is going to be the spot them very early on, so they can hope for backup. And I think Pasha already sees it. That's a third kill coming through here. Pasha just seems to be almost unstoppable. He goes down, but it's way too late in the round here. Get right to fall last. And that will be the round for Virtus.pro. 13 overall to the 8 of NiP. That means Virtus.pro are just 3 rounds away from winning NiP's map pick. And I do want to say this, there was a time when Virtus.pro were very, very good on this map, and it's actually never been clear to me why they stopped playing it. I've never understood what made them make that choice.
Is it too many maps? I mean, that was a really long time ago, right? And then it is like too many maps, I think. You know, it just got spread out to the point where they're like, okay, we're not feeling it on this map. Other teams are really good at it. Maybe we'll focus on this map over here and try and get an edge, right? The map decisions, and then they never actually just work their way back to Dust 2.
Yeah, but if I'm honest, I've never actually understood almost any of Virtus.pro's vetoes or anything else like that. It just seems to be really chaotic. But either way, they're showing that they still got it. What we have here is, though, a tactical timeout from NiP. Mm-hmm. They've got 2 minutes now to discuss what's going on and how they can bring it back. And they do desperately need them. They're about to lose this map for sure.
Yeah, they've got one per map. And so this actually comes down to the coach, comes down to the in-game leader. Some teams, they have fail-safe sort of scenarios where if they're down 7 rounds, they lose 7 rounds in a row, they just call for the timeout and say, right, okay, we need to figure out what's going wrong here. We need to focus up again and just take a breather. Other teams, it's almost like it's tactical in the sense that they're using it just to destabilize their opponents. Their opponents start to pick up steam, momentum. Boom, use a timeout. Let them cool off a little bit and go back to work. And so right now it's NiP, obviously, who are trying to figure out what can we do. Virtus.pro, they're 3 rounds away from picking up our map. Then we go into Cobblestone. That's Virtus.pro's turf. I mean, NiP need to come up with a solution within the next 2 rounds here. It's going to be looking pretty grim for him in this best of 3.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of attention on this map, obviously, to decide who's going to, well, I mean, this match in general, to decide who's going to make it into the semifinals. We already had Nico watching, but I've just got word that there may be another couple of pro players actually checking it out. Look at that. Seized from Na'Vi and all of my stuff from Fnatic, having a really good time and just checking out the game.
And look at that jersey that Seized is wearing. Oh. That is a Mouse Merch jersey. Oh. Seized, what is this?
Time to get the internet detectives on the case, I feel like.
Whose jersey is that?
So there could definitely be some real conspiracy theories coming into this. I like it. Well, 15 seconds and counting. We're going to get back into the game here. NiP, they're 5 rounds behind. And another 3 for Virtus.pro, and they'll walk away with the first map win. We're playing first to 16 rounds. See how it goes. And the worst thing is, they're actually walking right into a round where they can't afford rifles. They're going to go with pistols and no Kevlar.
And so I would say the entire aim here is to get that bomb plant. You get that bomb plant, even if you lose the round as T-side, you get bonus money for each of your players. And so that makes a big difference. When you're trying to save money to buy grenades, to buy rifles, to buy Kevlar armor, every dollar counts. And so NiP, they've invested a little bit. They have a couple of grenades to work with, and they're just hoping to get onto a site, swarm a site with the pistols, and get that bomb planted.
Bialy's in a fairly exposed position up on the scaffolding here. He doesn't get a lot of kills, which he does, so I'm just going to cancel the rest of that sentence. Three for him. If he hadn't, you can be run down up there, and there's really, it's really hard to get any backup, but that doesn't even matter. He does go down, but at that point, it's often almost no consequence. 14-8 here, and Virtus.pro very, very close at the moment. And I don't even know, NiP right now are looking to win 8 straight rounds in a row without making any mistakes. That's very difficult.
It's a tall order, but on T side, I mean, you take it one round at a time with the correct calls from Threat. I mean, that's the thing right now. A lot of the pressure now is falling on Threat, their in-game leader, their tactician, to come up with the correct call to figure out how Virtus.pro are setting up and how NiP can take advantage of that. And so NiP, they elect to go for a default kind of setup here. They're just canvassing the map. They aren't going for anything gimmicky, any kind of rush, early aggression. They're just spreading out, and they are looking to just gather that information on the defense. Where are they going to peek us from? Can we win a duel somewhere? How do we take advantage of that? Can I get lucky through the smoke with a spray? That's what Pyth is thinking.
I mean, any little bit matters, right? So maybe it would have worked. Got a three-man stack at the A-bomb site. Virtus.pro, I think, a little bit uneasy right now. I feel like they're not in great positions. They're just sort of shuffling around. Neo here, if he gets rushed down, that's going to be real bad. Instead, they're actually going to go aggressive. Pasha picking up the kill. Neo pushing forward, but all of NiP are right on the other side. And Exist will reply with two frags of his own. So that's going to make it a 3-on-3. And Snacks down on long still. NiP in a really weird position right now.
They still have quite a few nades to work with, though, NiP. There are still options. Two flash grenades, that could be good. Snacks has got that AWP in the perfect spot, but he has to worry about long. That's the one thing. They didn't get a full confirmation on just how many players were moving up on catwalk, Virtus.pro, and so he has to worry about two angles. He's kind of closed himself off here, though. He's at the car, but a single good flash grenade could ruin everything for him.
Molotov in. I'm not really sure where that was supposed to go, but I don't think up on catwalk anyway. They're jumping down by Ali there to try and help out. Get right. Still fighting on the other side. Pyth has gone down to Snacks. Get right. Turns around and picks up by Ali. That's an impressive kill. Spray through Taz. Look at that. Full spray. And now all on Exist. 1-on-2 with the AWP. He's going to go and challenge Snacks, and that might just have been a mistake. That will give Virtus.pro the map point at 15-8. They have plenty of time for defuse here, with the defuse kit and everything else.
Yeah, Snacks is just one step ahead. He's one of those cerebral players. He's capable of, you know, going brute force, toe-to-toe, you know, looking for spray fights. But when it comes to the mind games, it's so hard to keep up with Snacks. So hard to catch him off guard. And you saw it right there. He's already in the perfect spot. If Exist peeks him, boom, he's gonna hit that shot any day of the week. And so there's Threat. That's NiP's coach, their in-game leader, the man who's calling the shots on the team. And, well, obviously, the man with a lot of pressure on him to come up with the correct decision right now, because his players are struggling.
Used to play with Forrest and Get Right as well a long time ago, so definitely knows these players very well. Pasha making the jump by, goes back into the fight and takes out Freiburg. That is bold, but NiP, I don't think they were ready for it. They thought, that's it, they've all crossed over. There's not going to be any fight in middle. Can't make any assumptions. Bialy goes down to Forrest, and look at Neo. This is a position that was popular for like all of 2 days, and then it just went away. So I'm very curious if this is going to work out. He does give it up. That's a shame. I'd love to see that.
It is a bit of a one-and-done sort of position, right? You'll get like maybe one kill, if you're lucky two, but in general it'll be like you just get spotted and you're dead. And yeah. So Neo decides to fall back to a better position, a smarter one. And he needs to also be in position to rotate quickly over to support Pasha and soon to support Taz over here towards the B side, because it is looking like once NiP get control of mid, Get Right has currently lurked his way out through the mid doors, they will want to go for the B split. So a lot of this is on Pasha, and he's gonna catch Forrest with a nade in his hand. It couldn't have gone better for Pasha. There's the flash, but it's a little bit too late. And now Taz is alone, but Snacks is there to support.
Yeah, really, really important kill coming through. It's just sneaking in. He does get the spray on Taz. If not for that, it probably would have been map done. Now they have a real chance here. 2-on-2, they're going to be able to get the bomb plant out, assuming that Pyth can actually make it over. Is he going to... Yeah, so if he risks the jump, then he actually could get caught in the doorway there. Not going to happen. Exist will put the bomb down. Snacks going into the middle with Neo, and it looks like they're just going to try and see if they can make it through. So almost no grenades left. Neo with one flashbang, and that could be the main difference here.
One grenade. Is he actually going to commit it, though? That's the question. He is setting up for it. Snacks kind of drawing attention to himself. Now both players are out in the open on the bomb site. They will be able to pick up the kill on Exist, but Pythe is still alive in Upper Dark. And this is such an advantageous position for him. He's trying to draw Neo off of that bomb. He's looking for the fight. He's going to lose it. Neo again with the clutch. Match point, and you can see Pythe is not happy with that result. He knows he could have won that situation. It favored him, but somehow Neo comes through with a clutch. One kill short of the 30 bomb, though, of dropping 30 kills in a map, but still, one incredible performance from Neo.
Cannot believe it. Virtus.pro really, really strong at the Major, and still, it seems today, on absolute fire. 16-8 for them. It's very impressive. Now, earlier this evening, our host Rachel got into the full swing of things at the fan experience with Arby's giving out food with some special guests. Let's check that out.
Who is the greatest player of all time, Forrest or Neo?
That's a really hard question.
I know, it is.
It depends what month, what day.
It's really hard to answer. I don't know who to say.
Greatest player, I don't know.
It's a very tough question.
I think that it's very easy, and the answer is Neo.
I think Forrest from NiP.
I always like Neo
For me, he's the greatest of all time.
If you ask about only 1.6, I think it's Neo.
Regardless of the Counter-Strike version, I think Neo is the greatest player of all time. No matter what you give him, whether he has to be the in-game leader, whether he has to be the sniper or just a simple player, he is always fulfilling his role perfectly.
That's the ace for Neo and the defuse as well. He will get the MVP star for this one.
Neo won, I think, more majors than Forrest did in 1.6.
In terms of 1.6, I'm going to give it to Neo, that's for sure. Neo was a total beast in 1.6.
Yeah, I did some crazy stuff in 1.6. I used to be pretty dominant back in the days.
Forrest has been doing like extremely good in CSGO.
His raw skill, his ability to make openings for his team is just unmatched.
That was a big round for Forrest. They needed Forrest, the old legend, to come alive.
He's one of the best, and he's the most experienced player ever.
Someone who's played the game for a very long time with a lot of different teams and has achieved almost everything you can achieve at a high level.
Forrest is just one of the most talented and just flat-out gifted players who's ever played Counter-Strike.
He's looking for the first shot. Tech 9, boom, done. And he still can hit the shot on Sharks, and he does! Forrest with the clutch to make the difference.
He's been my top competitor in 1.6. And he's still doing a great job in CSGO, so I would say it's him, Forrest.
I'm gonna go and say, I'm the best CS player that's ever lived, but it's up to all other people to decide here.
JW likes to wash his hands before the games.
I do it a lot, but not as much as before.
My teammate has a strange ritual. Just when it's about to go live, he always leaves and washes his hands.
For some reason, if my hands are like dirty while I'm holding my gear or I just ate food, it feels kind of like a little OCD feeling. I don't like how it feels in my gear.
Domino's pregame rituals. Go on the offensive and Counter-Strike hunger. Order online now at dominoes.com. We'll be right back.
But I hope you're ready for it. It's Cobblestone coming up with both of our analysts picking Virtus.pro, the Polish team, to pull out on top, and they did show us a tremendous performance on Dust 2. No reason they can't repeat it here on Cobblestone, their own map pick. What do you think, Semler?
Exactly. This is home turf. It took a lot of bravery, obviously, to play that aggressive on Dust 2 to take the fight to NiP, to NiP on their map. But with Neo leading the way, anything was possible. And Virtus.pro, they really blew our minds in that first map. It was an incredible performance from Neo, and VP didn't let it go to waste. Now we go into their turf, and again, already, Snacks with the headshot on Freiburg.
Yeah, what a cheeky peek. Taking a fight with four people of NiP and coming out with a kill and escaping. That's just ridiculous. Someone should have been able to punish him then, but they just weren't. And now he's all the way back down. Backup has been called up for. Not only did he get the kill and survive, he also saw the rest of the team there. That's so much information. Now he's going for more with a little bit of backup from Neo coming in and doing a lot of damage onto Forest. He's down to 3 health here. NiP in a lot of trouble already in this round. Trying to see if they could maybe bring it back. The bomb is down there, but they've been slowed down so much.
Yeah, in the early rotation coming out here from Taz as well to back up the defense, to bolster the defense on the A site. They haven't completely forsaken B. There's still Pasha hanging around on that bomb site over there for Virtus.pro. So if NiP wanted to rotate back over there, Virtus.pro would be aware of it fairly quickly. But right now, VP, they are banking on NiP hitting this A site. They've got 4 players very close, 3 of them actually on the bomb site. This is going to be so tough now for NiP to get in here, especially if Forrest is going to get picked off so easily by Snacks, who just continues to reign supreme over here in danger. He's looking for more. Another headshot. Could go for another here on Exist, and he gets it. Can he get the ace? We saw it happen already. No, not this time. He gets shut down by Getright.
That is just not supposed to happen. That is so hard to pull off, and I think NiP were just caught by the sheer madness of what just happened. They have no way to predict that Snacks would just try and fight all of them at the same time. Not in any Counter-Strike playbook will you find a guide for how to do that. That's so ridiculous. And 101 Virtus.pro again with a great start. All of this is just completely nonsensical.
And this is brutal for NiP. On Dust 2, they didn't win a single pistol, and here it continues. That's 3 pistols in a row for Virtus.pro, and you can see the result of that. You win that pistol round, you get a lot of money, and that gives you the opportunity to buy the rifles, to buy the Kevlar, to make yourself just a tougher opponent. You see, NiP, they don't have the money after losing the round, and so they have to stay on pistols. So a difficult scenario here for NiP.
Interesting, though, that Getright's picked up a UMP, right? That's something we've sort of very rarely see. I think maybe 1 or 2 times before. And again, that means he doesn't have the helmet for his Kevlar vest, so
he doesn't have grenades.
No grenades either, but if he gets a headshot here, he's going to be down.
That's the main thing, though. If you're going to go for the UMP, you should hope that one of your teammates is going to be able to afford a few grenades to back this up. And so that actually means that Getright might have had the money to go for some grenades to make life easier here for his team. So he better get something out of this UMP. He nearly manages to take down Neo, clips him down to 22 HP. So you get something out of the investment so far. I actually almost want to see him hand it off to a teammate who has a helmet right now.
Yeah, especially when he's this low on health. That's a really logical choice. Just, you know, give him the Deagle or something like that. Maybe try and swap it out. Have Freiburg or Forrest play with the UMP. But they're sticking with it for the moment. Snacks is very much alone at the A side of the map. Getright making sure they're not being stuck up behind. So, I mean, if they got the kill on Snacks, they could maybe try and make a real push for the A site.
This is taking a bit too long. Now VP, they're starting to rotate Taz over towards the A site. Neo isn't too far away, playing in connector towards drop, and he's going to start rotating over, and here's the push. Comes in, NiP setting it up with the flash, but the anti-flash is coming in from Virtus.pro to slow them up, to stumble them. Forrest going to get picked. Snacks on the site, drops the bomb carrier, and now the rotation coming in from his mates. Getright will find Taz, and Getright with a 2nd kill on Snacks.
Jumping with the UMP as well. Forrest there with the tech line, and now it turns into a one-on-one. There's only 14 seconds. He has to go, Forrest. He can't actually wait for this fight. Bialys on the other side with just 4 health, so Forrest could probably win the fight, but he needs that bomb plant, and he's got to get it within the next 3 seconds. Otherwise, it's going to be too late. Just going to get it in time, and now Bialy out in the open. Forrest has got a very, very good shot at winning this. He's got 100% health, all the armor he could want. Bialy, he's going to be out in a second, and triple kill for Forrest. NiP right back in the round. And that's really big. That's Getright with a double and Forrest with a triple.
And that's, yeah, exactly. And it's Getright actually gets something out of the UMP. Fair enough, Getright. Jumping headshot onto Snacks. Okay, then.
Now look at that reaction. These are the 2 players you want from NiP to wake up. The Getright and Forrest combination can bring any team in the world to its knees. They are so good when they're both working, so if that's going to be the case here, we could see NiP with a very interesting map right now. pistols and armor is what's picked up on the Virtus.pro side, as they did lose that round. So they don't want to sort of give in immediately to NiP. They want to keep the pressure on here.
Oh, that's the thing, exactly. Because NiP win a force buy, they win an eco round, essentially. That gives them the money right back. You can see they're kind of balancing it out. A couple of rifles, a few SMGs to back it up in case Virtus.pro are going for an eco with no Kevlar. So VP, they would love to run into those SMGs. With the Kevlar, they can actually take the fight against that smaller caliber bullet, put it that way, right? Deals less damage than Kevlar, and so VP, they've given themselves a little bit of an edge to work with here in this round. We'll see if it actually pays off. And so far, they're playing very standard, spread out across the map, but still with three players on this B site, and it looks like NiP, they want to head to this bomb site.
Yeah, and I think that's a solid choice, although if you look at the mini-map in that left corner there, Virtus.pro are starting to creep in. So they're making sort of a tactical choice here to put every single member on the B side, which is where NiP are headed over. So even if they just have pistols, this is a very, very strong position to be in. And Pasha, he's hiding in the corner. If they forget to check that one corner here, close range with the CSET 75, he's going to be out a little bit too early, and that might have been a big mistake on his part. Neo turning around, but he goes down. Taz to pick up the only kill so far for Virtus.pro, and that's going to be it. NiP making that round look easy.
Yeah, very solid performance there from NiP. They keep their cool. And it's true, NiP, wherever they go, they've got fans. It's nuts. But yeah, Clash of the Titans, Pasha and Getright going toe-to-toe so far on this second map. The big thing there is that, I mean, it's good that we have a picture of Pasha, because Pasha, that's just one of those unfortunate situations where in that position with the CZ75, if he waits a second longer, he could have wrecked NiP. He could get double spray, and it completely changes the situation. But instead, he goes out a second too early. They're too far away for him to be effective with the pistol. And we see Getright, you know, just completely take control of the situation, right? So, not a lucky break that time for VP.
Well, now things get slightly worse as they are in a round with, again, pistols, but this time they don't even have the luxury of Kevlar vests, so they're gonna be much softer targets here, and we'll see if NiP can't. They should be able to just easily clean up a round like this one. And because they have all these SMGs still alive, they would be making a lot of money from a round like this, so they should be.
That's the plan. You get double the money with these SMGs versus the rifles and the pistols. And so we're putting a lot of emphasis on the economy, on the money, because you need it to buy the grenades, to buy the Kevlar, to buy the rifles. The more you can make, the better your better situation, better position you're in. So Pasha, he's playing plateau. He's going to be the one peeking, but Forrest instantly going to get the punish on him. And NiP, they're just taking their time. This is how you play an anti-eco. You just slowly work your way onto the site versus the pistols.
Don't want to take too much time, because Snax is actually walking up behind, though. Really good job on Getright checking that out, but it's one of those things that Virtus.pro are quite happy to do on this map. And we were criticizing some of the other teams. I think Cloud9 was playing on this map in the other quarterfinals, and we were sort of talking about a little bit how they weren't being very proactive. They were just staying in place, weren't really pushing up too far. Snax loves doing that on the A side of middle there.
Okay, then. I'm going to venture a guess here and think that, no, it's not going to happen. Okay, never mind. I was going to say that this could be a prime situation for NiP to go for a power play and to just say, we know that you don't have that much money to go off of. You're not going to have the anti-rush nades. We're sticking on three SMGs. Makes me think they might want to rush plateau and just try and completely just overwhelm the defense very quickly. But instead, NiP, they're deciding to split towards A and take their time about it. Look for the close quarters combat.
Makes me think they may have actually lost their minds here. This is, I mean, a really unnecessary gamble in my opinion. I have no idea why NiP are doing this, and it seems like true madness. But look at that carpet of fire being laid down in front of Taz. He's going to have to fall back. And for some odd reason, this madness seems to be working for NiP. They have the bomb down, they're in equal numbers, and they're using all these grenades to buy so much time. Virtus.pro keep having to wait. In fact, they're just going to run away. They have all the rifles. I don't think they realized that NiP had three SMGs.
Because it's just completely nonsensical. Nobody does this. I mean, G2 does it sometimes, maybe with the MP9s. They get cheeky, but I mean, running out with SMGs onto a site like this is very uncommon. It's a huge risk taken by NiP. It pays off this time. But yeah, that is a scary play to go for if you're NiP. It's really, like I was just talking about the money, it's the long con on the money. That's what NiP are aiming for. If they don't invest in the rifles and they win the round, they just continue to stack up that cash.
I almost wish it hadn't worked, because it will encourage other people to follow down the same spiral of insanity that NiP were on here. I mean, the fact that Snax doesn't get to turn around exactly in time is a little bit unfortunate. But great stuff for NiP. I mean, the money that they're going to have based off of rounds like these is going to be out of control for Virtus.pro.
Like, They're four of those players are above $8,000. That's a terrific economy to have right now. If you're NIP at the beginning of the half like this, it sets you up nicely to just avoid those eco rounds where you're sitting on pistols. Virtus.pro now have the pressure on them to come up big here in this next round. And now, Hythe wants to apply a little bit of pressure early on. He does put forward the aggressive smoke, so that's going to force some nades out of Virtus.pro's side. You can see the incendiaries going down just in case there was going to be a rush, but instead it's going to be a rush towards A. Sight Snacks gets two kills, but Forest and Exist will trade. And we're into a three-on-three scenario now. VP have to retake this A site.
Look at how effectively they're using those grenades. Exist picks up a kill on Neo. It's still a 2-on-2 now. As Exist goes down, Bailey quick with the rotation. The bomb has been picked up. There's so much time left for NIP to do this 2v2. They don't really have to force anything, but they're at least grouped up, whereas Bailey is alone, and he's very much trapped behind the little hut here, trying to take the fight, and almost gets the kill on Pyth through the light post there. It's going to be Pasha going down. Get Right helping out with a kill, and NIP making it 5-1 in their favor. Neo and Pasha haven't even killed anyone yet. They're both at zero right now, which is not great.
No, especially nice, awesome, all right. That's a cool way to watch some games. But I mean, what's going on here is just, you know, the drop from Neo. He's just ran out of gas, it seems. Pasha also never really took off on Dust 2. And we're not really seeing him get too many opportunities. I mean, NIP, they aren't really hitting that B site. When they did, VP were egoing. And so, you know, Pasha hasn't really had the time to shine. Now, however, that might change. Pasha's got the M4, and NIP are grouped up on Plateau. They're looking towards long. They might be going for an early push. And I'm wondering, Pasha, he's dancing on the edge of this smoke. How is this going to work out?
Exist opens up with a big kill there. Pasha charging through. There's the one, there's the follow-up, looking for a third, and Pasha gonna take down three members of NIP and putting his team in a decent position here. Snacks can still do it. The bomb is down, though. Pyth, one health left. If Snacks only had an HD grenade, that would be a certain kill, but now he has to go and fight him just with the rifle here. Oh, and one click, what's happening? Snacks takes him out, but he can't deal with Get Right. He's gonna fall. And NIP make it to 6. What a mad round.
That clutch.
And just, I mean, this is an interesting talking point, right? We saw the absolute ridiculous situation that Neo was in on the first map. He got so many frags, 29 kills, I think it was, in the first map. Now he's still at 0, and we're starting in the 8th round now. So you can really have that, you know, super high, and then suddenly you're just not doing anything at all.
Yeah, the very lows. No, it certainly isn't pretty. Snacks really aggressive, straight into the halls, and he might be able to pull a fast one here. It seems like NIP, though, they were close enough to realize something is amiss, and yep, Freiberg's gonna check the angle. Not gonna get caught off guard. Snacks trying to go for the jumping P250. Okay, then. But he's not gonna be able to make it out alive. Pyth holding the angle, and Taz not able to support his teammate. So, now NIP, they have some information to go off of, at least. Realizing that VP, once again, the economy is broken for them, and so NIP straight into default kinds of holes, just waiting to see if Virtus.pro are going to go for some more shenanigans here.
Now, I guess we should put into perspective sort of the map balance here, just so people are aware that this is a very terrorist-sided map. We're expecting NIP to win by far the majority of the rounds, and if Virtus.pro could even win sort of 5 rounds or something on their CT side, they're still feeling competitive. They can still actually do something in this map. But it's more, I think, the impressive nature of what NIP are doing here. That's a little bit scary.
It's after Virtus.pro win the pistol as well.
Yeah.
You expect to get 3 rounds if you win the pistol. And so then you're sitting, you know, the CT pistol on cobble, it's great. You get 3 rounds, and then you have to start dealing with the rifles. Pasha, once again, holds the line, though. He's going to get 2 kills. Neil there to help. Not going to get the follow-up. He's so close. And Pyth right on the edge. It's Get Right trading places, and Get Right going to town. 2 kills for him. But again, Pasha with the flashy plays.
And look, if that fight had continued for another couple of seconds, Bailey would have been here. He's going to get the kill with the C-set, long range. Now it's one-on-one versus Get Right. The bomb is right in front of him, just 18 seconds left here. And Bailey, he clutches it, gets both players. What a massive round here for Virtus.pro. A much-needed one, and a lot of it thanks to Pasha and that dreaded Mag 7.
What was that? Okay. There was like somebody camera flashing in my eyes. I was like, what's going on? The round is way too intense. All of a sudden, I'm losing
consciousness. The paparazzi that are coming after you.
No, but they should be coming after Bialy. What a huge win with the Lurk. It didn't work for Snacks in the last round. They came so close for his pro. This time around, Bialy, however, is the hero. And he finally breaks the streak. And now Snacks has that AWP. He might be able to find the angle. Yes, he hunts down Freiberg right on the edge of that smoke. And so Virtus.pro with the opening kill in the round. Now the pressure's on NiP to come up with something big here. They're the ones who are going to have to group up and just try and barrel their way onto a site.
And here's also you see the sort of the results of the early rounds that NiP had. Even if they lose this round, they can still buy just fine. Their economy is just looking so good here. See everyone, almost everyone about 3,000, and that's just really scary. A big bank on get right there. So they're going to be just fine even losing this round. See if Virtus.pro can make it consecutive, though. That's always important when you're playing the CT side. You don't want to win a round and then go back to losing. Then things get really tough.
Absolutely, that's the key. They'll be back to pistols, and NiP will just run away with this first half. And so VP right now, they have a lot riding on this one round. The flash goes into underpass to buy a little bit of time. The bomb is currently making its way there for NiP. With 45 seconds left on this clock, it's starting to get to that point where NiP are going to have to commit to a bomb site. And so now they're just going to get everybody lined up, paired up. Exist making some steps, though, so Taz knows somebody's close. Perfect pop flash. Taz completely blind, and now it's all on Snacks. He wins the duel versus Forrest, and he's still alive. Looks towards Wood Snacks. Warbank shot onto Pipe, and he's still here. They can't get rid of this guy.
And Snacks is an absolute beast, and when he's in this kind of a mood, you've got to be really worried. A little bit of a weird fight going on there, but Pasha eventually comes out on top. But Snacks, you know, we were talking about how Neo isn't one of the people who's supposed to be doing well. I feel like when Snacks gets into play on this team, it's so hard to stop. He's got such a weird style. He's got such weird intuition. His timing is always just a little bit off from what you'd expect, and it catches everybody off guard. So we'll see if that's going to continue. He's got 12 kills. He's actually top fragging, in spite of the fact that they've been just taking a beating for, what, 6 rounds in a row almost. But now they're finally fighting back.
Yeah, he's waking up and he's continuing to go aggressive. Wow, this peak! And he gets the duel versus Pythe, but that takes some bravery right there. Just throws himself out into the open and somehow gets the angle right, takes down Pythe. And again, Virtus.pro have the opening kill. Snacks just dominating that side of the map right now. And so NiP, they're set up towards the B halls. Maybe just because of Snacks. They're like, we're done with this guy, actually. Let's go over there. We had a little bit more luck. Let's go towards that B site.
Well, Forrest is here to try and take a fight. Snacks is down behind that smoke somewhere. So both snipers trying to feel each other out there, but not really going to connect with anything. Drop room there for the moment, fired off with a Molotov, but looks like GetRight does want to take a little bit of a peek into it.
This is the ideal setup now. Being very methodical here, Freiberg and GetRight working together as a duo. The incendiary to clear out that close angle, and the smoke goes down a block off connector. And so this is just step by step setting it up here for NiP to push out onto the B site. Big spray battle there, and Bihali is going to win it versus GetRight. Taz and Pasha, everybody getting a piece of the action. It's on Forrest now, 1v4, and it's not looking good. He is going to get spotted, and Bihali will eventually hunt him down. 4 rounds on the board now for Virtus.pro. They continue to run it back versus NiP 6 rounds, and finally they've succeeded in breaking NiP's economy. Question is now, Anders, in this sort of scenario, right? Would NiP go for the force? They're right on the edge.
Yeah, this actually is a real dilemma, because if they do it and it fails, then they gift Virtus.pro just a terrific first half, right? And if they don't, I mean, yeah, there is no right or wrong. It's just like a feeling. I think you've got to make up your mind about how likely you think it is that you're going to end up winning. And it looks like Virtus.pro, like NiP, they just decide to even out the money a little bit. So they buy some pistols, but not that many. GetRight trying to create a distraction as the rest of NiP make their way up towards the A side. Snacks not impressed at all, though.
Yeah, and that sets it up nicely for Taz. He saw the second man behind the smoke as well. And point blank, Snacks, no scope, takes down Pyth. Forrest is now stuck in a bit of an awkward spot. Taz is like, I hope if I don't move, he won't see me. It's not going to happen, though. Taz, you know, he may be the old man of CS, but his eyesight's still pretty sharp.
He's not gone full T-Rex yet.
Not quite.
Well, that's going to make it 5-6, and we said 5 rounds, and they're competitive. If they get more than this, NiP should start to feel really scared. Now it's a double op setup again here for Virtus.pro and NiP. I'm curious what they're going to show us. Freiberg and the rest of the team making their way out into the open. And Snack's going to go for the fight once again. Did he spot it? I don't think he did. They're on the other side. He sees a grenade coming through with a blind guess there. Not quite going to work out.
He fluffs his grenade as well there. He might have been able to actually do quite a bit of damage to Exist. Not going to happen. This is a bit of a nasty spot as well. If somebody tries to go for the wall bang through that wooden door, might draw a shot out from Snacks, and we'll see if it actually works. But NiP right now just trying to make a lot of noise over on this A site. We're still very early on in the round, however, so they still have time to maneuver. They can make noise over here and then try and create a diversion, wrap back towards that B site. But with the bomb dropped in A halls real close to the site, it definitely makes you think that NiP wants to commit.
Right now, Pasha is in a great position up on the plateau here. He's going to have really, really early warning if anything happens at B. That's also why they're being allowed to sneak three men into the A bomb site. Normally, you'd only have one. So they have a huge presence right now on A, and that's all thanks to Pasha's position. So overall, this is really good tactical and positional play coming out of the Polish side. And NiP don't even know it. They don't even know that they're about to walk into a wall of counter-terrorists here. Snacks with the shot right in the shoulder of Exist, and he's almost down as well. Taz will be going down, and Neo out in the open. So they return with two kills, and that's really big. Snacks, he did it once. This time he's going to fail the shot. Tries to buy a little bit of time with a flashbang. He's going to peek out. They almost line up. But it's just gonna be the one kill. That was scary. You can get two for one with that sniper rifle. That's how powerful it is. The bomb now making its way onto the site, and it's gonna be planted with just 10 seconds left here.
Yeah, talk about cutting it close for NiP. And also, what prompted the rotation from Virtus.pro, where they just decide to up and start rotating towards that B site? That cost them everything. They had the perfect position, and that's the difficulty of playing CT on Cobble. It's just that you have so little information to go off of on the CT side, on the defense, the side that Virtus.pro are currently playing. And so a lot of the time it is coming down to feel based off of information, timings, what happened the last time you played against this team, when did they usually go for this kind of play, et cetera. You're trying to just sift through your knowledge to say, right, at this time we need to be in this place on the map. And so something must have triggered Virtus.pro there to say, right, we need to actually rotate towards B because NiP, that's where they're about to go. And it just completely backfired on them here.
A very important round for the Swedes. They only lose Freiburg. They save the AWP. Pasha saves his on the other side. And actually, Virtus.pro have a very good economy going into this round, so they're going to be able to buy everything they could possibly want. No auto sniper in play. We haven't seen what yet here at the quarterfinals, but it's actually Virtus.pro is one of the teams that really love it.
Yeah, Pasha. He's used it in the past, certainly. Could definitely put it to good use. I like to see him with the AWP as well. Just because, I mean, Pasha with the AWP, I mean, he was, for quite some time actually, one of the better AWPers in the world. Stepped away from the sniper rifle for a bit, but we've seen him start to come back to the sniper rifle recently, so good to see. A little bit of a duel there at the beginning over on A site. Snacks once again showing his versatility, changing up his position, and now he actually wants to go aggressive on long, and we'll see if it actually works.
A lot of NiP members on the other side. Last time he escaped, this time look at that, right around the corner. Python's gonna be there, and Snacks still manages to slip away. It's so ridiculous. It looked like if they peek there, they're just gonna get the kill on him immediately, but that doesn't quite work out. I'm surprised Forrest didn't get the hit early on. It looked like he was dead on Snacks, so not sure if it caught the wall, maybe.
Just incendiaries all over the place trying to clear out these angles, and once again, NiP, they'll be getting control of A long. But that is a setup, it looks like. They still got that bomb actually over towards B halls. So they've made quite a bit of noise over here throughout the first minute of this round. And now with 55 seconds left, they start to rotate back towards the other bomb site. So they're hoping, once again, to just catch VP off guard here. They want VP to actually stack towards A so that the defense will be just a little weaker over on the B site.
They left Freiburg, and you can tell that that's very intentional, so I'm wondering how they're going to make it work. I mean, if Snacks try to push out, that would be one thing. Pasha going to go down, and that's on the plateau. That leaves Neo alone on the bomb side. This is not a good position. He's going to have to come up big here. He's got a grenade in hand, and it's just not going to get his rifle out in time. Byth opening up with another kill, taking down by Ali. And Taz, well, ultimately, it doesn't even matter what Freiburg's role was in this round. It's not even going to be needed.
He's just not going to find anybody, right? I mean, he might be able to spot out Taz here eventually. Taz will win the duel. So that's an AK here for Taz to try and save instead of that M4 if he wants. But he's actually trying to play for time, as it just wants to actually make a run for it. Doesn't want to get caught out in the open. He doesn't know if Freiburg was alone, if somebody was coming in from Connector. He's going for the mind games here, Taz. So we'll see if it works. Pyth might get caught looking the wrong way. Yep. And so Taz not even going to give away his position. He really wants to try and hold on to this M4. That would be a huge save for him right now. The economy definitely pretty weak over for Virtus.pro right now. They don't have a whole lot of money to work with. So if he can save this M4, that would be huge. And he's actually worked his way back around to save an AWP.
Massive.
That is awesome. That's $4,750 that he just saved for his team. Now that can go to Snacks, who's just been lethal with it so far this map.
Oh, that's Taco from the SK team, and he's dead on as well. This matchup is always going to be good, isn't it? So Taco, one of the friendlier players in the scene, I feel. Always in a good mood.
Well, what's nuts is like Taz and Neo have played together for like almost over a decade now, I think. Like one of the longest standing duos in CS, in pro gaming, period. It's nuts,
yeah,
the history
Pasher,
that they have.
Yeah. The original members, the Golden Five lineup. So some stuff there, some real history. With Cuban as their coach as well, so he's still around. Only missing Lord somewhere. Got 14 rounds in, and Snacks already being wall banked down to 15 health. So NiP, after letting go of 4 rounds in a row earlier in this half, they seem to be back in the driver's seat here. And if they win this round, Virtus.pro would go into the last of the half with really no economy at all. That would be dreadful.
Oh, that would set it up perfectly. I mean, they would get stuck at the 5 rounds, which is kind of pushing it. You really do want to be picking up at least 6 rounds on the CT side of Cobble. So we'll see if they'll be able to come through here. Still all 5 players alive for each team. Taz is going to get Molotov down into the open, and he wins the duel straight up versus Pyth. Big mistake made there by Pyth. He had to win that fight, because now this could prompt the rotation over towards the B site here for Virtus.pro. 4 players soon to be set up, and Pasha continues to thin the herd. Forrest and Exist are down, and he even gets a wallbang shot onto Freiburg. Just a little bit of a tag. Or I'm lying, he didn't. But it still looked cool.
It was real close, wasn't it? Get Right is going to be going down, and Neo playing close to the wall here, even jumping and shooting. Why not at this point? They're in a 1-on-5, a 1-on-4. It's not going to matter really that much. Freiburg hiding in the corner, but any second now, he's going to be out of the round here, trying to see if he could fall back, and he's got 20 seconds left. So regardless, he can't even make it to the A-bomb site in time. Better to, I think, just try and save what they've got. They actually would need this AK. Not all of NiP could buy the next round, so I'm not sure why Freiburg is trying to run for this 1-on-4. Getting the bomb plant wouldn't even help them. That doesn't actually make up for what they would lose. And not even going to check Snacks. Oh, he's not going to go for the knife. I feel cheated. I feel robbed, Semler.
I did too, actually. I was thinking. But Snacks not going to leave it up to chance. Just decides to play it safe, get the job done, and now he set up Virtus.pro to get a 7th round. Could be possible. NiP still had just enough money to get that AWP in play. This is the kind of play that Pasha is capable of, right? He's played Plateau on Cobble for so long. Definitely one of the more experienced players for that position on the map.
Oh man, they just had enough money. I think they had more of a bank than I realized on Forest, so that's going to help out a little bit. Just a couple of grenades missing, but that's not too bad. NiP going for their almost patented smoke setup there. Get Right pushing out on Plateau, and he's got Exist behind him, so a big presence early on. Then they're going to slow it down, and now the grenades are going to rain in that the rest of NiP are throwing, and Neo with the opening kill on Get Right sets it up nicely for Virtus.pro. They already got 6 rounds, they're looking for a 7th, but Exist answering back quickly. Pasha behind the chicken coop there, trying to see if he can make it out, but they're going to bang him down right through the smoke, and it's all on Taz, 1-on-3. Freiburg actually pre-firing that. And that's going to be 9-6 in favor of NiP. So overall, I would say a very even matchup. Just like on Dust 2, first half, very even between the two teams.
Now, I think the big key here is going to be NiP finally breaking the streak and winning a pistol round. If they could do that, that's going to set them up beautifully to take it to a 3rd map here in this best of 3. And so that's what we're waiting to see here. If NiP can keep up this pace, they certainly put on a good show for us in the first half. We'll see after the break if they can continue with it.
Welcome back to E-League, everyone. After the first map, I had a chance to step aside with the coach of Virtus.pro, Kuban, and I asked him about these mind games that they're playing today. Ninjas in pajamas they knew would pick Dust 2 if they left it open, because historically, they haven't done well on that map. So Virtus.pro practiced for this exact scenario. Now on Cobble, another non-traditional pick for them, Coach Kuban says, "We know Cobble is a good map for them, but we are just better." What do you think of that confidence, Anders?
I mean, that is exactly the sort of stuff I want to hear. I'm tired of listening to pro players, you know, being all nice and saying, well, any given Sunday, maybe not. I don't want to hear that. I want the confidence, and I love it. Kuban definitely on point.
It's certainly better than the interview we had with him at the Major, where he was like, actually, we just don't kind of practice that map. At least they put some practice in on Dust2 this time. At least they came prepared.
Now look at this stuff here. This is Neo on the first map, 122 ADR. And then on Cobble, we've got 61. He's got 3 kills. What happened? Who stole Neo's powers?
His mojo?
Yeah, maybe.
He has been around long enough to have been cryogenically frozen at some point. You know, maybe.
There is always that. You know, they need to plug him back into the Matrix and get him fired up here for the second half. It is 9-6 favoring NiP with just 3 rounds. So whoever wins the pistol round could make a really swift comeback or just straight win the map here. NiP, they already lost Dust 2. So if they don't make it on this one, they're not even going to make it to the semifinals. And Virtus.pro will instead. That's at the Cobb Energy Center next week. Already the action live here. And Exist trying to reload in the middle of Virtus.pro. That's never a good idea. Freiburg going to be going down. Get right as well. And Virtus.pro, they're crushing NiP on this B bombsite. Forrest trying to salvage what's left, and he gets 2 great kills, but it is just too late. Forrest, 3rd kill coming through. It looked impressive, but it was too late.
Not a single pistol round picked up for Virtus, or for NiP so far. Virtus.pro have just dominated in these pistols, and that was some vintage Virtus.pro that we saw right there. No fear, straight charge, just taking the fight to NiP, not letting him get set up. Overrunning the defense so quickly that NiP, they just can't react. And even a heroic attempt there by Forrest at the end wasn't enough. That's the kind of Virtus.pro that's just going to take control of this T side here on Cobble. And Kuban, he might be right. You might be saying, you know, we're just better. We're going to get onto that favorite side, and we're just going to maul these kids.
I mean, that's certainly looking like it at the moment. With that kind of a start, it could get wildly out of control. Again, a very T-sided map. So Virtus.pro play these next 2 rounds like they should, then we're going to have a tied scoreline at 9-9. And at that point, you have to favor Virtus.pro, just given the map balance.
Exactly. And well, you can already see the difference here between both teams, how they want to approach their CT side. NiP not making the investment into Kevlar, similar to what we saw on Dust 2 as well. They're going just for the CZ75. They want to make sure that they have as many nades as possible, as much money as possible in the 19th round, when they should be able to buy again. Anything is possible, though, with some CZ75s, a Deagle on Freiburg, and a P250 on Pi. So we'll see if they can get the drop on Virtus.pro here. Close quarters with those pistols. That's what they're hoping for.
Get Ryan actually might be in a very good position here. It's going to be hard for them to challenge him without exposing themselves somewhere else, but they're going to get a really good trade in. Freiburg, the only one to reply on Neo so far, who just is not having a really good game, is he, Neo? Just keeps running into trouble. Freiburg, Pive down, and the assist as well. So the rest of Virtus.pro functioning just fine, and they only lose Neo.
Yeah, and I think Neo, he'll be perfectly happy with that. Get the round, all that matters, really. No need for the flash. And right now, we're actually seeing a little bit more of the standard play coming out here from Virtus.pro as far as the players are concerned. It's Snacks, it's Bialy sitting at the top of the scoreboard right now. They're the new stars that have come in. They're the ones who kind of lead the charge for Virtus.pro. They're leaned on, really, to get the job done.
That's 4 monitors and a laptop and maybe some more. That guy's watching just a lot of E-League, and I don't know if anyone can match that, but I'd certainly be interested to see if someone had a more conclusive setup than that. Taz opening up, and NiP, a lot of members here at the B-bomb site, and not really going to make a big difference. They get 2 kills in, but still not much of a chance for them to bring it back. 2-on-3 sounds good, but there shouldn't be much of a chance here.
This is just so scary, actually. Virtus.pro, I mean, showing no respect to NiP right now with how aggressive they're being. And Get Right shouldn't lose. Yeah, exactly. Snacks is eventually going to hunt him down with that UMP. It's all on Forrest now, but he's been spotted, and he's not long for this world. Neo will pick up a kill on the round, save the AK as well. That's the important bit. Definitely want to drop that SMG for the rifle. And now we get into that first buy round here for NiP. The 19th round tied 9-9, and it's straight to the double AWP. They aren't wasting any time at all here, NiP. This is a very expensive round. No wonder they've been trying to save up as much money as possible.
Yeah, an interesting situation. Just Pyth lacking the helmet there. He's got the Kevlar, but not the helmet for it. That's only an issue if he runs into the UMP, because the AK-47 is going to kill you in one bullet anyway. So only if he runs into the submachine gun is it really going to matter. Bit of a failed grenade there, but ultimately just trying to create a bit of a presence early on, see if maybe they could draw someone from NiP out.
Quite a few nades thrown in, but really only from one person. That's Neo. He sacrifices all of his nades, and so NiP, they're counting those nades. They're just saying, right, okay, well, we don't know quite yet. Well, now they will. When they see all four other sets of nades coming in, that's going to be a bit of a tell that Virtus.pro are going to come over towards this B site, and you can see Exist boosted up on the box. Not quite sure which way to look. He's in a bit of an awkward spot.
That's one of the reasons why this is such a tough position to play. He's going to fall off just as they come through. Snacks jumping through with the SMG to take him out, and Neo getting a kill just before he dies. Pyth is out of the round as well. Get Right taking a fight here with the Mag 7, but he fails to get another kill in, and it's going to be Forrest to take down by Ali. Now a one-on-one. Pasha versus Forrest. AWP versus AK, and the bomb is out on Forrest's side, and now look at this. This is where experience really begins to matter. Forrest is going to try and play some extremely deep mind game against Pasha. Is he really expecting Pasha to pick up the bomb and then go A? That's got to be it. Forrest is thinking once he gets the bomb, he's going to try and mind game me, so I will already have set the trap. That is more than just next level.
That's unreal, actually. That's a huge risk, considering he had the angle with the op to hold onto that bomb. Now Pasha gets a free bomb plant, and he can actually set up for the afterplant. He doesn't know where Forrest is coming from, though, so he's actually a little bit worried. Has to take his time before he makes his way out into the corner, but now this is such a tricky position for Forrest. Forrest, he has no idea where Pasha is on this bomb site. He could be at Plateau, he's checking corners. This is actually gonna buy a lot of time for Pasha, and Pasha just steps out of nowhere.
Wow.
And wins the clutch 1v1 versus Forrest, who just ended up outthinking himself there, just making it a little bit too complicated.
If that had worked, then Forrest would have looked like an absolute god, but doesn't quite happen. And actually, a very rare moment where you see Neo getting emotionally frustrated at sort of not doing too well here. He's got more experience than almost anyone playing this game, so it's almost a bit shocking to see that, that maybe his own sort of lack of performance is maybe getting to him a little bit here.
He is usually very reserved, very humble. I mean, doesn't show a lot. And so, yeah, to see that is actually a bit eye-opening, you're right. Still, I mean, everybody just, there's a lot of tension obviously running on this. Virtus.pro up 1-0 right now in the score. And I mean, what's at stake? A semifinal spot in the Cobb Energy Center next week. Top four finish here in the first season of E-League. That would be huge. And so, I mean, NIP, they're not allowed to make any mistakes, but neither are VP. Taz is going to get the drop on Forrest, but Freiburg, in the meantime, has taken out Neo. That's an underpass, and a bit of a stack happening over here for NIP. We'll see if Pyth can actually capitalize on this. Not going to work. Pasha with two kills, opening up the bomb site, and now it's Get Right and Exist rotating in, hoping to be effective here, but Get Right, long range with the shotgun, not exactly the best gun to have there in that scenario.
But definitely not, and Snacks just cleaning up that round, no problem at all. That's going to give us an 11-9 scoreline. So Virtus.pro favored by two rounds here. But the real problem for NIP is just the economy. They're now going to be in a position where every round they lose, they're not going to have money to buy the following round. And that's a really bad problem to have.
It's exactly the situation that VP found themselves in at the beginning of that first half. They won the pistol, and then they lost five consecutive rounds. And so that is because if you're on the CT side, it costs more money to go for a full buy with the rifles and the grenades. You find yourself having to sit on pistols, just saving up money so you can actually afford to go for the rifles. And so right now, VP, they're in a prime position, and they are once again taking over A and actually spreading over towards B as well. This is a mind game coming in here from Virtus.pro. They want to make some noise over here on B, draw the attention of the defense over there to that bomb site, and in the meantime, Virtus.pro, they're in control of long A, and this could get awkward for Freiburg. He's boosted up on the wall. He will be vulnerable to Taz, actually working his way out here. Taz gonna spot him! Instant reaction from Taz, and that's the opening kill.
A great start, and Forrest getting shot in the back by Pasha. Virtus.pro actually just playing a really good tactical game on NIP here. Those smokes that go down in the B that were thrown from so far away, you saw them sort of follow them over the castle wall there. They're cutting up the B bomb site, which is normally an indication that there will be a B attack happening. It's a big dedication to throw that many smokes in. So if you're not even going to push behind it, it's almost a bit of a waste, but not when you can throw that kind of a fake and suddenly have three people walking out on the A bomb site. They just weren't ready for it in IP, and that's going to cost them the round as well. Get Right here trying to salvage the rifle, but it's not going to happen. Virtus.pro individually looking really well, but tactically just really showing us some cool stuff here. 12-9 being the scoreline.
They look terrific. So far, a flawless T-side for Virtus.pro. They have not dropped a single round versus NiP. And so NiP now, they're scrambling. They're looking for a solution. And they fall into that trap. They now have so little money, they have to save. GetRight had just enough to go for the shotgun. It made a little bit of sense. Freiburg as well. But they're still trying to save money for the next round where they can afford to get the rifles again. But by that time, Virtus.pro, they'll be up on 14 rounds. This is first to 16 rounds. So Virtus.pro, they only need four to win that semifinal spot.
Forrest, good position with the Deagle, but he was flashed, so he couldn't obviously see anything. And now the grenades are going to follow it up here. Taz spraying furiously and taking down Freiburg. And that is all of the A defense already gone here. So the rest of NiP, they could fight, they could save it. I'm not really sure it makes a difference because they're going to need more than just a max 7 and a CZ to try and bring it back in the upcoming round here. We're getting dangerously close. Might be able to get by Ali killed here. That would be a nice frag to get that AK-47 away.
Get right, such a teammate as well. It's like, I will burn for you, Exist. Go, get the kill. And Exist lets him down. What a horrible teammate, Exist. Come on, man.
Just a little bit of a failure there. Get right, trying again. Gonna be fighting Snacks, and I don't know how he didn't get that kill. We'll just pretend that never happened and move on to the next round.
Get right certainly wishes. You saw the reaction there from Get right. Also a player who shows a lot of emotion on his face. Well, yeah, didn't look too happy with how that situation panned out. And now, actually, we have a little bit of a curveball getting thrown here by NiP. You mentioned the SCAR 20, the auto sniper in the first half. Virtus.pro, they like to use it every now and again. Exist as well will sometimes go for the SCAR 20, and so...
Yeah, this is a gun that does bring out a lot of emotion, but not so much on the player side, more on the community side. People really hate this rifle. I don't think it's actually, there's nothing rational about that hatred, but it is interesting. Exist all the way back to Chicken Coop with that auto sniper. Gonna see if he can maybe rein in some terror with it. It isn't a one-shot kill to the body, it takes two bullets, but it does fire fairly rapidly, so not gonna make it a big difference.
Virtus.pro right now, once again, going for those, the nades that make it look like it's going to be a B execute. They're leaving their options open. They haven't fully committed to the B site. They're actually trying to get some kind of rotation coming out here from NiP. Slowly bringing the bomb back towards A. Neo gonna catch Freiburg with a nade in his hand and fully commits to it. Runs right up slope into Forrest, waiting arms. Forrest gonna drop Taz. That's the bomb out in the open as well. And so the full rotation coming out from NiP. Now towards this A site, right into Snacks' waiting arms, and Neo with the dig.
What a great round from Neo here. It's time he got back in the game a little bit by Ellie. And Pasha gonna combine to get the kill on Python. Now Exist here alone, auto sniper in hand. This seems like a mad idea to try and win the round, but he will get the first kill on Neo. That's a good start. Runs back and takes a little bit of damage from the Molotov. He's still got two kills to get before he can claim the round, but if he doesn't go for it, then Virtus.pro almost gonna win the map anyway, so you can kind of understand why he wants to do it. He spots out one person, the bomb is down as well, out in the open, and it's gonna be Pasha to shut him down. Auto sniper didn't do much, and it's 14-9 here. Virtus.pro, what a team right now. And again, they did play well at the major, but this is, they seem to be on the incline again.
This is terrific. They're just showing the depth in this roster, right? Neo can just go completely ham on a map and just carry his team. And then they're just capable of actually showing the true depth in the sense that now it's Snacks, it's Bialy, Pasha, everybody stepping up, everybody in the high teens on the frags. They're all doing their part. And right now, NiP, they cannot seem to break the streak that's happening in this second half. They're getting completely dominated. Virtus.pro on 14 rounds now. NiP have yet to pick up a single round in the second half.
And the equipment they have to fight this round is very poor. They've got the FAMAS, they got the MAG 7, and one CZ-75, Python with the M4. It is looking really scary at the moment. And again, it's so hard on the CT side of this map to change anything up. It's hard for them to push aggressively and actually fight Virtus.pro. They sort of have to wait until they see something out of the terrorist side here.
Oh, Forrest is getting toasty, still takes one with him though. Drops Pasha, goes duck hunting. And while Freiburg, he is going to get caught looking the wrong way. Neo with the perfect time to peek. Get right trying to get up close with the CZ-75. Might be able to catch Snacks off guard and actually does manage to land a bullet. But that's not enough. He needs to get a kill.
Trying to get through. I mean, it's just a question of timing. Hard for him to really guess at it. They were still looking for it. The Python exists left. They've left the B bomb site where Bialy's now confirming there's no one on the site. And Neo going to bring the bomb in behind here. This is almost, I don't even think NiP can't really realistically fight this. I mean, it's not fun to try and save into a 15th round, but at the same time, you throw away these rifles, then you really have nothing, and Virtus.pro might just take the map and the match here.
It is looking very good. Taz already in drop. He's going to catch the rotator. That's exist. Does get spotted. Doesn't take any damage, but still, now that's the information that counts. Virtus.pro know where he's coming from, although Miali for some reason thought it would be wise to spray into connector. Getting caught off guard a little bit there, but still, Virtus.pro, they've got so much money, they don't care. They can full buy it. They have everything they need.
Well, I'm hearing actual Virtus.pro chants here. 15-9. It's good that they're making some noise, because there's a good chance you guys will be seeing him at the Cobb Energy Center very soon indeed. They're one round away in NIP. They would have to play flawlessly. There is a thing called overtime if it turns out 15-15, so that's what they're fighting for right now. I don't know how they could possibly do that. They have won exactly zero rounds on the second half.
Well, this aggression again, showing no fear, no respect. Driver going to get overwhelmed, and it's the first plow at its finest. Taz with the kill on Forrest. Garrett goes leaping through the smoke, only to die at the hand of Neo, and it is now, again, Virtus.pro with a huge advantage. Snacks there to trade with Python. It's a 3-on-1 scenario. Exists the last man alive once again here for NIP. And while it's not for long, Pass is there to end his dreams. 16-9 finish, and Virtus.pro completely and utterly destroy NIP in the second half.
Very, very impressive, and look at the celebrations there as well. A team of old schoolers, but they definitely still have the fire. They're going to be facing Mouseports in the semifinals over at the Cobb Energy Center. That's going to be next week. But what an absolutely impressive run here. You can just never underestimate this team. There are periods in time where it seems like they're just out of it. They're not there. They play very badly, and then suddenly they show up, and they're just utterly on fire.